Good morning to all. So we are discussing polynomial and its operations. We already implemented how to perform addition of two polynomials. So we compare the exponent terms. When the exponent terms are equal, then the coefficients of the both the polynomials are added. If when the exponents are not equal, we cannot perform addition of coefficients. So we are already discussed that how to perform addition. This concept, there are two polynomials. After addition of these two polynomials, this is the resultant polynomial. A polynomial is represented in the form of matrix. So there are two ways to represent the polynomials. One is array representation, another is linked list representation. So in array representation, so we take a two-dimensional array. In two-dimensional array, the one column is the coefficient, another column is exponent. Zeroth column is the coefficient, first column is exponent. We compare the exponents of the first term with the exponent of the second term. When the exponent terms are equal, then we can add the coefficient terms. When the exponents are equal, we cannot perform addition. So this is the two polynomials. This is the first polynomial and this is the second polynomial. So after performing addition of these two polynomials, this is the resultant polynomial. So like this we can perform addition. So this is the algorithm for polynomial addition. We are already implemented in C++ also. So now we are in polynomial multiplication. So to perform polynomial multiplication, each coefficient term of first polynomial is multiplied with the coefficient of second polynomial and exponents are added. So in polynomial multiplication, each coefficient of first polynomial is multiplied by all the coefficients of second polynomial, and each exponent of the first polynomial is added with all the exponent terms of the second polynomial. So like this we can perform polynomial multiplication. When a polynomial, first polynomial has n1 terms and second polynomial has n2 terms, then the resultant polynomial has n1 into n2 terms. For example, when the first polynomial has 4 terms and second polynomial has 5 terms, then the resultant polynomial has 5 into 4, 20 terms. So this is the first polynomial. So 7x power 5, 8x power 4, 2x cube equal to 0. This is the first polynomial. 10x power 7, 15x power 5 is the second polynomial. The first polynomial has 3 terms and the second polynomial has 2 terms. When you multiply these two polynomials, then the resultant polynomial has 6 terms because 3 into 2 is 6. So the coefficient of the first term is multiplied by all the coefficients of the second polynomial. So 7 into 10, 70x power, 4 exponents are added, 5 plus 7, 12. 7 into 15, 105, exponents 5 plus 5, 10. So then we go for the second term, 8 into 10, 80, x power 11, 8 into 15, 120, x power 9. 2 into 10, 20, x power 10, 2 into 15, 30, x power 8. Finally, this is the result. When you represent this polynomial in a matrix way, so this is the representation. The first polynomial has 3 terms, 7x power 5, 8x power 4, 2x cube. The second polynomial is 10x power 7, 15x square. So to perform this, the exponent term of this polynomial is multiplied by add with the exponent term of second polynomial, and we can perform it multiplication of coefficients. 7 into 10. Okay. Chapandi.
Fine arts on admit challenge, sir.
Video, eppudu video.
Fine arts. Network problem, sir.
Fine arts, seven layer ga. Waiting lo layer. Only 3 students are there. 507 is not in there. Lakshmi Lucky. Amma yana?
Yes, sir.
Number the login over manje. So 7 into 10, 70. X power 12. 7 into 15, 105, so 120. So then similarly 8 into 10, 80 x power 11, so 8 into 15, 120 x power 9. 2 into 10, 20 x power 10, and 2 into 15, 30 x power 8. This is the process. So this is the representation. So this is the algorithm. This is the algorithm. First of all, let us assume that the first polynomial has n1 terms and second polynomial has n2 terms. When we are multiplication, so coefficients are multiplied and exponents are added. This is the result. So this is the algorithm for polynomial multiplication. So now we go for implementation. How to implement this polynomial by using in C++. How to implement this polynomial in C++. So this is the program polynomial. So we are already, this is the last class program, we are polynomial addition. So it also contains polynomial multiplication. So we are using a friend function to multiply. So the naturally we use friend functions. When we use friend functions, a non-member function want to access the private data members of a class, at that time we use a friend function. Friend function is used when a non-member function want to access the private data members of a class. So the friend function has a keyword friend. This is the keyword friend. The return type of the polynomial is polynomial. So the function name, polynomial multiply, this is the function name. So it has two parameters, polynomial and polynomial. That means the function polynomial multiply will accept two inputs polynomials and produce one output polynomial, output. That means that the type of friend function is a function which accept input as an object and returns an object called as. Polynomial. So return type, the return type of the function is polynomial. Then you have to write the function name, poly multiply. Poly multiply. Polynomial p1 comma polynomial p2. There are two polynomial objects. Polynomial p3. Polynomial p3 or p4 you can write, no problem. So we need some local variables, int I equal to 0, I comma j comma k equal to 0. So I need three variables. So then we can multiply. So how we can multiply? So the first term of for I equal to 0, I less than p1 dot terms. So the number of terms in first polynomial is assigned to the variable terms. P1 dot terms I plus plus. For j equal to 0, j less than p2 dot terms, the number of terms in second polynomial p2 dot terms j plus plus. Then p3 polynomial 3, we called as p3 dot. So we say that p3, So P3 dot P of K through 0th column equal to P1 dot P of P3 dot poly of PYLY. Poly of K of A through P1 dot poly of I through 0th column into P2 dot poly of J through 0th column. Coefficients are 0th column. That's why P3 dot poly of K of 0. So P3 coefficient equal to P1 coefficient into P2 coefficient. P1 coefficient into P2 coefficient. Similarly, P3 dot poly of K of first column equal to P1, P1 dot poly of ith row first column plus plus P2 dot poly of jth row first column. So we multiply the coefficients and perform addition exponents k plus plus. So this is the process. Finally, P3 dot terms equal to P1 dot terms into P2 dot terms. Return P3. So not P, we are mentioned P4. P4 I will write P3. No problem. These are the local variables. That's why no problem. P3 dot P1. Each P1 has P1 terms. P2 has P2 terms. Coefficients are multiplied and exponents are added. After that, we increment the k value. Finally, P3 dot terms equal to P1 dot terms into P2 dot terms and return P3. So this is the algorithm for multiply. P1, P2, P3, comma, P4. P4 equal to poly multiply P1, comma, P2. I will add this also. P3 polynomial addition. P4 equal to poly multiply P1 comma P2. So P4 equal to poly multiply P1 comma P2. Finally, we write poly add result. See out. Poly multiply result. P4 dot write polynomial this the so we are performed. So we will give two input two and we can add P1, P2, P3, P4. P1 is the polynomial addition, P2, P4 is the polynomial multiplication. We will give two. So by taking these two, we can perform it. Yes. enter first polynomial. For example, the first polynomial is 4x, so enter number of terms. So let us assume the number of terms for the first polynomial is 2. So 4x power 5 and 3x square. This is the first polynomial. Enter number of terms of second polynomial, 3. 10x power 5, 14x power 4, 12x square. This is the second polynomial. So 4x power 5, 3x square is the first polynomial. Second polynomial is 10x power 5, 14x power 4, 12x square. When we performed addition, 5 plus 4 exponents are equal, 4 plus 1, 14x power 5, and 14x power 4, and 2 exponents are 2 plus 12, 15, 15x power 15, correct. So when we performed multiplication, 2 into 3, 6 terms, 4 into 10, 10, 4 into 10, sorry, 4 into 10, 40, 40x power 10, okay, and again 4 into 56 x power 9, okay, again 4 into 12, 48 x power 7, okay, 3 into 10, 3 into 10, 1 minute, 30, 2 plus 5, 7, yes, 7, second 3, 42, again 36, yes, we are getting correct result. So we are representing this polynomial, this is the output we are getting. So when you are performed addition and multiplication, so we can print the result in exponent form also. So we can show the result in exponent also. Why not 7 is not in the room? She is lured in the from the room. That's why I'm not admit them. 507. 507 is not in the room. Is not in waiting room. Actually, she is logging with his name, Lakshmi Lucky. So I already told so many number of times. Students can log in with your number only, but no, some students are not logged in with your name. That's why. And later, so some students are not admitted because of, so they are not switched on their videos. So if they are switched on their videos, then only I will admit them. Otherwise, I won't admit any student because there is a problem. Somebody is joined with some other body. That's. So we can print the output in a polynomial. This is the one polynomial. So we can represent the output in some other model also. For I equal to 0, I less than terms minus 1, I plus plus. See out first we call polynomial poly of I through 0th column, then we go for x power cap. This we represent in quotations, x power cap, then poly of I through first column. And after that, we represent plus symbol. Then see out poly of I throw 0th column x cap. Poly of I throw first column equal to 0. This is the another model to represent polynomial. We see it. For example, number of terms 2. So 4, 5, and 8, 2. There are 2 terms. Second polynomial, we have 3 terms, and the 3 terms are 10x power 5, 10x power 6, 14x power 4, 12x square. This term. So this is the way. Instead of writing 10x power 11 plus 56, this is the way. So instead I will remove the that one. 4x power 5 plus 8x square equal to 0. This is the first polynomial, second polynomial, that is the second polynomial, and this is the third polynomial. This is the final polynomial. So we can write it polynomial way. 10x power 6 plus 14x power 5 plus 14x power 4 plus 20x square equal to 0. 14x power 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 terms. Yes. So this is the another model to represent polynomial. So then I will remove the previous one. So enter first term, number of terms of first polynomial 2. So the first polynomial is 4, 5 and 82. This is the first polynomial. Second polynomial has 3 terms, and 3 terms are 10x power 6, 12x power 5, 8x cube. This is the second polynomial. So this is the result. The first polynomial is 4x power 5 plus 8x square equal to 0. Second polynomial is 10x power 6 plus 12x power 5 plus 8x cube equal to 0. These are the two polynomials we are given. Polyadd result. So whenever we performed addition, so only the exponent terms 4 plus 5, 4 plus 12, 16. Exponent term is added and remaining terms, when exponents are equal, then they are added. Otherwise, the exponent terms are not added. So and this is the multiplication. So when we are performed multiplication, 14x power 11 plus 48x power 10 plus 32x power 8 plus 80x power 8. So we can actually here we are getting the exponent terms 8 and 8. So we can simplify it, no problem. We have to write additional code for simplification. So here we are getting, so 32x power 8 plus 80 plus 80x power 8. So when we are added 112x power 8. So that is the simplification process. To perform simplification, you have to write additional code. If you write some additional code, then we can perform the simplification in the case of multiplication only. It will occur in multiplication only. Addition is not occurs. In multiplication, it will be occurs. You have to write simplification code. Simplification code means then you have to totally arrange all of them in a way. So you have to sort the exponents, sort the all the terms in based on exponent, then you have to check it. When both are equal, then we can perform add. So when you perform like this, we can simplify it. That is another process that somewhat complicated issue. So that this is the way to perform addition of multiplication and addition of two polynomials. This one. So this is about polynomial addition. So one is, this also very important work, how to represent, how to add two polynomials and how to multiply two polynomials. So what is the way to represent the polynomials? So this is the polynomial addition. So this is the polynomial by using, we are specified polynomials by using by using. Polynomials can also represent in a linked list also. So for example, so this is the polynomials. Linked list representation of polynomials. a polynomial can also represent in linked list. Polynomial can also represent in linked list. Each node of a list contains coefficient, exponent, and pointer, end pointer address. Address of next node. So a polynomial can also be represented in a linked list. We can also, each node of a list contains coefficient, exponent, and address of a node. The node declaration of linked list representation of the polynomial class node. Class why right? Poly node. Polynomial node, that's why poly node, right? In the coefficient, we have the coefficient, int coefficient, comma, exponent. These are the two terms, and poly node star p pointer star next. This is the representation of polynomial. So this is the node declaration of polynomials. This is the node declaration. So each node will consist of the coefficient and exponent, and we have the pointer, polynode star pointer. So suppose the linked list, what is the linked list representation? So suppose this is the polynomial. So what is the linked list representation of this polynomial? So for example, so this is the polynomial. The link, what is the linked list? So this is the polynomial. Then I will go for one small, instead of going very big expression, it's very difficult to draw, that's why I will write in small way. If it is book, it's difficult to draw the diagrams, that is only problem, otherwise no problem. Suppose this is my polynomial. So then what is the linked list representation of this polynomial? So this is the my polynomial. So 7x power 5, 8x power 4, and so 2x cube plus 7 equal to 0. This is my polynomial. So then what is the linked list representation of this polynomial? So we draw a diagram by using linked list. This is first node. This is the second node. This is the third node. This is the fourth node. Actually, we need four nodes. Four. Each node will consist of three fields. I'll write 7, 5. At this. 7, 5. And 8, 4, 2, 3. Then 7, 0. So this so 7x4 5 can be represented like this. 8x4 4. This is 8x4 4. This is 2x cube. So this is 7x4 0. Then you have to connect the nodes. The first node address will contain the second node. Similarly, the second node will consist of address of third node. The third node will consist of address of fourth node. And so the last node address is null. So this is the starting node. We called as first node address. We called as start. This is the first node address. The first node address is stored in start variable. This is the linked list representation of the polynomial. Say polynomial is represent both arrays and linked list. So this is the linked list. Suppose you want to write a program by using linked list. You have to use the same as first of all you have to allocate the storage, then enter coefficient exponent. If the list is empty, so you make it start. Otherwise, instead of entering one number, you have to enter two numbers, exponent and coefficient. That's all. So like this, we can create two linked lists. After creation of two linked lists, then we can perform. We compare the exponent terms, and we are when equal, then we can perform addition. This is the linked list representation. We can write algorithm also, no problem. So however, somewhat difficult procedure. Otherwise, we can write algorithm also. You have to call create module as 2 times. When you call the create module at 2 times, we are created a list, two lists, two polynomial lists. After that, you have to compare. So you have to take the two lists, first list and second list. So while suppose we have to take current one, that is current two. Current one not equal to null and current two not equal to null. So we can write it, no problem. So there is some difficult. I will write a small algorithm so you can understand whether here I will write the algorithm by using you to try to understand it. That's enough. Algorithm poly add. So polynomial poly node start one. Comma poly node start. CURR 1 equal to start 1, CURR 2 equal to start 2. We have CURR 1, CURR 2. So while CURR 1 not equal to null and CURR 2 not equal to null. So these are two capitals, CURR1 not equal to null and CURR2 not equal to null. This is the algorithm, not a complete program. CURR3. So if CURR1 of exponent EXPO is equal to CURR2 arrow exponent, if the exponent of first polynomial is equal to the exponent of second polynomial, then CURR3 of coefficient equal to CURR1 of coefficient plus CURR2 of coefficient, CURR3 arrow exponent equal to CURR1 arrow exponent, CURR1 equal to CURR1 dot next, CURR2 equal to CURR2 dot next, then we go for CURR3. So I'll write law at end. I will add that new module, new statement. Else, if not equal, else. If CURR1 of exponent is greater than CURR2 or exponent, if first polynomial exponent is greater than second polynomial exponent, we can add first polynomial terms. If first polynomial CURR coefficient equal to CURR1 coefficient, CURR1 exponent, CURR1 equal to 0. Else, we can add this. So CURR2 coefficient. CURR2 equal to CURR2 dot x. We can add, so again we called CURR3 dot next equal to new node. Then you have to say no node, just enough. Then you have to CURR equal to CURR3. 3 equal to CURR3 dot next. So we are allocated. This is some simple algorithm for linked list representation. So this is the linked list representation. So when this is capitals, I'll make it as uppercase, and this is also uppercase. So this is the, so when we are using, say again, if there may be first nodes, so while CURR1 not equal to null, we have to add all the terms of CURR1 not equal to null, so we have to add this. Then how to write it this way. Similarly CURR2. While CURR2 not equal to null. It's one complicated issue. We go for some simple way. So this is the finally CURR3.txt equal to null. So this is the one algorithm for polynomial addition by using linked list. Suppose I want linked list. So we have the two lists, CURR1 and CURR2. Let us. So current list, first node points to the current one, second list point to the current two. I'll compare the two lists. So comparison means while CURR1 not equal to null and CURR2 not equal to null. So each node has two fields, coefficient and exponent. So it is necessary to compare the exponents. That's why if CURR1 exponent is equal to CURR2 exponent, if the exponents are equal, then you have to add a CURR1 coefficient plus CURR2 coefficient and assign to CURR3 coefficient. If CURR3 exponent equal to CURR1 exponent, then you have to move to next node. CURR1 equal to CURR1.next, CURR2 equal to CURR2.next. If exponents are not equal, we can assign the highest exponent term. If CURR1 exponent is greater than CURR2 exponent, you have to assign the first exponent terms to third. Else, if it is otherwise, you have to assign the second exponent term, CURR2. Finally, we can create a new node. So again, the current equal to current3.next equal to new node, current3 equal to current3.next. That's enough. So sometimes the first list may have some terms or second list may have some terms. So if while current one not equal to null, that means first list has some terms, so we can add it. So if current3 equal to current CURR1 coefficient, CURR1 exponent, current 1 equal to current 1 dot next, then we have to create a new node and assign to current 3 equal to current 3 dot next. Similarly, if some second node has some terms, you have to assign them. So current 2 equal to current 2 dot next. That's again we go for there is a current 2 equal to current 2 dot next. Current 2 equal to current 2 dot next. So then we have finally we make it as current 3 dot next equal to null. So this is the way we are using. So we can add it. This is the way for current 3 equal to new node. Spark 3 equal to current. So this is small algorithm. This algorithm for polynomial by called as polynomial addition by using linked list. So this is the linked list representation of polynomials. So this is about polynomial addition, polynomial multiplication, and linked list representation of polynomials. So this is called as polynomials. Tomorrow we go for sparse matrix, another one. So which is also very important. This when completed sparse matrix, second unit will be completed. So this is a completely programming paper. Students are requested to say it is completely programming paper. Students can understand the concept and write the programming your own way, or otherwise watch the YouTube videos, understand the concept and explain and implement yourself. Then only we'll get the ideas. If you by heart you cannot get. మా అందరికి చెప్తున్నాను, మీరు ఛానల్ సబ్స్క్రైబ్ చేసుకోండి, అట్లానే మీ ఫ్రెండ్స్ కూడా చెప్పండి అమ్మా ఒకసారి. సో మీ ఫ్రెండ్స్ని కూడా సబ్స్క్రైబ్ చేసుకోవచ్చు, అందుకని ఒకసారి మీ ఫ్రెండ్స్ కూడా చెప్పి సబ్స్క్రైబ్ చేసుకోమని చెప్పండి. ఓకేనా? ఇది ఈరోజు క్లాస్ అమ్మా, పాలినామియల్ ఎడిషన్ అండ్ మల్టిప్లికేషన్ అన్నమాట. మీరు కంప్లీట్గా మీరు యూట్యూబ్లో చూసుకుంటే మీకు మళ్ళీ మొత్తం వస్తుంది, యూట్యూబ్లో మొత్తం మీకు డీటెయిల్గా ఉంటుంది, డీటెయిల్గా మీరు అక్కడి నుంచి రాసుకోవచ్చు. సో ఇది ఇంక ఇది అక్కడ ఉంటుంది కూడా, అందువల్ల మళ్ళీ సపరేట్గా చేయవలసిన పని లేదు. ఓకే, బాయ్.